Welcome YouTube to my Minecraft video here. This is going to be more of a training video for some of those people who are not so familiar with the game. Right now we are in the Ice Plains Spike biome, which can be very hard to find that game. We're standing on one of the towers right now, and it's the beginning of the day here. So we're going to be talking about several topics here. We're going to be doing some inventory hot clicking, as well as some basic farming and armor. And then we're going to be mining some special ores down the surface here. And then along with that, we're going to be teaching you several techniques that I have developed through the past few months. So let's get started here with the inventory. So right now, we're wearing armor right now, and one of the ways to quickly remove your armor here is to shift and mouse click on these items here. And you can put it back up. Now you can also do this with your inventory and your backpack area here. And this will put it back into your hotkey area. You can put it back. So one of the other techniques here to quickly get your items is to use the hotkey bar here, which is 1, 2, 3, all the way up to 9. So you click on, you hover your mouse over one of the items here, and then you click 4, and I'm going to click 3 on this guy here. I'm going to go back to this guy here, and you can essentially mix it up here within the bars. One of the other techniques out there is in the whole crafting area, where you're gonna have to click on the item and then click on a specific shape within the crafting area. So essentially, to do that quickly, you just click on this guy here, and then you drag it all over the areas you want to affect. And then you can click on this here. Be very careful with the shift button here. If you were to do that and then click on the crafting table, you create a whole bunch of tables. So I'm going to shift over here instead so that we don't make that. Okay, so it's very beautiful out here in the frozen part of Minecraft world. Got a flower biome over there. That's where our base is right now. So one of the techniques out here that I'm going to teach you is the F3 button. Shows you a whole bunch of interesting stuff. What I'm focusing here are the XYZ coordinates. So we have the X and Z coordinates, which corresponds with the north and south, and east and west. The Y coordinate is your depth. So right now we're at 107 blocks above the bottom of the map. Typically, when you're on the surface, that's around 62. So I head back down here. Here's that guy here. So I'm going to make a small waterfall so that I can quickly go down this guy here without falling to my death. One's a very tall tower. Let's go back. Let's go to our base here. So this ice biome has a bunch of neat surfaces here. It has the ice as well as the snow. Okay, and then we got our farm here. Let me turn off the coordinates here so that I can show you more of the surface here. So let's go get some farming. So I'm going to click on this grass. And then we're going to get some seeds. And I'm going to use these seeds here, along with this hoe. I'm getting my own technique. And let's make the hole right here. It's two metal surfaces up here. All right, two over here, and then two down there. We already have a stone hoe, so we don't have to make that. Just tilt it here, plant the seeds. And then you can essentially wait for it to grow. If you had skeleton bones, which we don't have here, you can quickly grow it. So let's go to the next step here. So the armor is a very important item in this game here. Try to click. There we go. So this is your chest plate item. These are your pantalones, your helmet, I should do that, and then your booties right here. And then you can also make a bucket here. And then you can make some more ladders. I forgot my technique already. Okay, so let me show you something very cool. We're going to make a pocket of air. Space it out like here, and then as you can see, we can breathe within this water. So this can be used to make underwater bases. It can also be used if you're drowning. It's very interesting, but enough about that. Let's go down to the surface. Okay. Before I do that, let me get some water. So I did scout out this area beforehand, and I put in a bunch of torches. Essentially putting in the torches do make it more difficult for the monsters to spawn, but we have a little creeper over there that has refused to go away. We have to deal with that guy later on. So let me show you some ores that I spotted here already. Okay, so the first ore we have spotted is the lapis lazuli. We're gonna mine that with a iron pickaxe. So as some of you have already figured out, the certain pickaxe that we use is very important, because if we use a stone pickaxe on something like gold or diamonds, I'll show you later on, we won't get any of that. We need a higher metal material, such as this guy here. Some of you may have known the wooden pickaxes do not work on the iron, but the stone ones do. So we can get the gold here. Okay, we got redstone here, which is very useful. And making compasses as well as that circuitry. There are a lot of uses for that, and I won't go into the details. Iron coal over there. Okay, we've got some more coal over here. This is a very precious diamond. So, make my materials here. those who don't know this, but the diamonds are very difficult to find. So I'm gonna cut around this area. Make sure there's no lava underneath. Looks to be safe. Okay, and we got some diamonds. So I'm going to create a diamond pickaxe with this guy here. Show you what we can use with it. Okay, so this is the lava we've seen before. Put water above this guy to create obsidian. Diamond pickaxe, you can harvest this obsidian here, and it's going to take a very long time. With this item, you can create a nether portal, and that will take you to a whole new different map. So let me show you the design to make this. It's not a lot of space here. This guy here is as a dirt. Okay, so imagine these guys are obsidian. We're gonna build it like this: two on the bottom, three on the side. Flint and steel. We're gonna light this guy up. You guys should enjoy the trip over there. So let me create some final items. There's that gold. Okay, with the gold and the redstone, we're gonna make a clock. Looks like it's sunset outside. With the same item here. And with some iron, we're going to create a compass. Now, the compass will point to your original spawn point, which can change if you've created a bed. But that's essentially it. Right now, we're at 13 blocks above the circuit, the bottom of the map. And that's usually where you find the most diamonds. But that should be it. Thank you for watching.